All right, thank you and good morning. This is probably the most well-attended information session I've done in the last 3 years in my capacity as Secretary for the Rhodes Scholarships for South Australia, so hats off to you. I hope to see applications from at least a few of you. The last Rhodes Scholars from University of South Australia were awarded in 2006 and 2007 to Ryan Manuel and Amy King, and their time at Oxford overlapped with mine. I was a U.S. scholar elected in 2006. And in my role as secretary, my goal is to encourage and assist you in your application to win a Rhodes Scholarship so that you can have full funding to attend University of Oxford and pursue a second BA, a second BS, perhaps a master's, or a DPhil, the PhD at Oxford. And any way in which I can do that, please let me know. So at the end of this, there will be contact details, including my mobile. I have collaborators here at University of South Australia, just across the road in your beautiful new science building. So I'm very happy to meet with you in the city to discuss your application. So a little bit about the Rhodes Scholarship. Like I said before, it's one of the oldest and most prestigious global scholarships. More than 100 are awarded around the world every year, and that's to study specifically at the University of Oxford. And in Australia specifically, 9 are awarded, 6 in each state, and 3 from the territories and at-large bids. So last year, for instance, there was a student who had studied at UniSA who was nominated to interview again for a second chance at the at-large round. So I hope to see more applicants this year from UniSA. And these scholarships have been a tradition that started in Australia since 1903. And as a Rhodes Scholar, you join a community of nearly 8,000 scholars and around the world. Now, like I said before, there are 9 elected each year. There are 6 in each state and 3 at large, and also applicants from the territories. And in each of the states, we will nominate this year. We will elect 1 Rhodes Scholar from South Australia, and we have the opportunity to put 2 forth to the at-large round. So there's a potential to have 3 Rhodes Scholars from South Australia. So about the eligibility, can I apply? So there are some restrictions, so it's important to take note of these. If you have any questions about any of these eligibility issues, please contact me, because there have been issues where we've brought them to the attention of the National Secretary and received exemptions in some cases. So please talk to me if you have any questions about these. The first one is you must be an Australian citizen. That is a hard, fast rule to win an Australian Rhodes Scholarship. And you must have lived in Australia for at least 2 of the last 10 years. That's been relaxed since rules in previous years. You must have completed at least 2 years of high school in Australia, 2 years of secondary schooling in Australia. You must have completed an honors or master's degree, and it needs to be at a first-class level by the 15th of June, 2019. And the first-class honors and a strong academic record is critical, because not only do you have to be admitted to Oxford, but you have to be admitted to one of the colleges. And last year was one of the most challenging years on record to have our Rhodes Scholars be admitted to the programs of their choice and be admitted to a college. There are age restrictions for the Rhodes, so unlike the John Monash Scholarship, we do have a hard, fast age restriction, and basically you must be younger than 26. So you have to be younger than 26 as of the 1st of October, 2019, and you can only apply for a Rhodes Scholarship twice. So these are the eligibility issues to take into consideration. So what is the Rhodes Scholarship? What selection criteria will we use to evaluate each applicant? These selection criteria were set out in the will of Cecil Rhodes. So Cecil Rhodes was a diamond baron, and he used his wealth gained from his exploits in Africa to establish this scholarship. The scholarship means something very different today, but we still follow the mandate of the will to use these selection criteria to put motivated, talented, curious individuals from around the world and Oxford so they can have one of the highest quality educations possible. And so you need a strong academic record. That's the first criteria, okay? we're looking for literary and scholastic achievements. But it's not enough to be smart. Everyone in this room is going to be intelligent. All of our applicants will be intelligent. We're looking for something beyond that. We're looking for people with motivation to do things they're not told to do in their degree. We're looking for people who use their energy to develop their talents to the full, their energy to go solve big challenges in the world. We're looking for applicants who have devotion to truth, courage, and duty, and sympathy for and protection of the weak. And so the motto for Rhodes Scholars is to fight the world's fight, and have a moral force and character and instincts to lead. So leadership is a criteria that's quite important in your selection as a Rhodes Scholar. So there is no one formula for a Rhodes Scholarship. I mean, so Bob Hawke, for instance, right, was a Rhodes Scholar, so this building is named after him, right? And so many heads of state have been Rhodes Scholars, but that doesn't mean that you have to go down that path as a Rhodes Scholar. There are 8,000 Rhodes Scholars that are involved in many different aspects of life, and many live right here in Adelaide, okay? And it's been a while, but there are two that have been elected from South Australia. So it is something that's attainable. We're interested in people that are motivated, curious, that they take scholarship seriously, and they use their scholarship, their talents, and their interests to help others, okay? So that's something to keep in mind. It's not restricted in any area of study. You don't have to do law, medicine, or engineering, though most of our applicants come from those areas. We're interested in applicants who've studied management, international development, nursing, economics. We haven't had many applicants from any of those areas, but we're certainly happy to discuss with you how you can prepare your application in an effective way. So where can I apply? So I'm representing the jurisdiction of South Australia for the Rhodes Scholarship, but you might be interested in applying in a different jurisdiction. So these are rules that have changed in the last round. So you can apply in the state or territory in which you have completed your most recent degree, usually your honors or master's degree, or where you did most of your schooling. So we will have interstate applicants applying for South Australian Rhodes Scholarships, and some South Australian students may very well apply to a different jurisdiction, say if they did their high school in a different state or territory. If you're studying overseas, because this is recorded, and hopefully there are some joining us virtually over the web, you can apply in the state or territory in which you attended your secondary school or high school. And if you're from the territories, you'll apply for the territories round, the territory round and the at-large bid. To apply, everything is online. The applications open the 1st of July. I strongly encourage you to contact myself or my co-secretary, John Williams, at the University of Adelaide to discuss your application before it opens. If this is something that's of interest to you, please approach us. We'll sit down, we'll have a coffee, and we'll talk about the best ways in which you can prepare for this application. And the applications close on the 14th of September. So the mechanics of applying, what do you need to submit to us? The first and probably the most important thing is your personal statement. This is your introduction to the committee. And this is an important thing to do, whether you're applying for the Rhodes or any of the other prestigious scholarships you've heard about today. It's also important to help you clarify who you are, how you define yourself, how you want to define yourself in the future, and how you communicate your goals to the selection committee. We want to hear your story. We want to hear what you're passionate about. We want to hear why going to Oxford is going to enable you to succeed and help others. Okay? So it's an important part of the application, and one which we very much look forward to reading as we work with the selection panel. You'll need to supply a CV, but up to 3 pages, so you have plenty of room to tell us about all of the wonderful, exciting, and interesting things that you've done during your university career. If you're applying for a DPhil, if you're going to do a PhD, you need to include a 2-page research proposal that says what you intend on doing and who you plan on working with, or what group or what area, and some type of email confirmation that says, sure, if she or he wins a Rhodes Scholarship, we're very happy to support their candidature to study for a DPhil in this area. We require 6 letters. So for those of you who aren't applying this round in your first, second, or third year, you need to think about cultivating relationships with your mentors, perhaps your research supervisor, people that you volunteered with. so they can be your advocate. So they know you well enough that they can trumpet your successes and your interests and how you've made an impact on others in their letters. And we do take these letters quite seriously because it's an external evaluation of what you've done and who you are personally and the prospects for you continuing your upward trajectory. Three of those letters must be from academics. The other three can come from any other mentor. They could be academics as well, but you want to keep in mind that we need to evaluate them against the selection criteria. So it may very well be someone that you've worked with in a volunteer work or a service project. Okay, so you want to keep that in mind. And of course, you need to supply your transcripts and some evidence of your residency or nationality. So like I said before, applications open July 1st. We shortlist the applicants and invite you for an interview here in Adelaide, and that will happen towards the end of October. We elect the South Australia Rhodes Scholar on the day of the interviews, and should we have up to two nominees that we feel are electable as Rhodes Scholars, we will send them to Canberra for the next round of at-large interviews and then a chance to win one of the at-large scholarships. So like I said before, the Rhodes Scholarship covers all of your fees and you get a stipend. So you can pursue your academic and research interest unfettered by financial concerns. It also includes health insurance, airfare, and you cannot hold this scholarship concurrently with another scholarship. Like I said before, there are many prominent individuals around the world from Australia and abroad that are Rhodes Scholars. So several heads of state from Australia, including Bob Hawke, again, our current Prime Minister, Malcolm Turnbull, Bill Clinton from the US, and some of my heroes in journalism, Nick Kristof, and the recent Pulitzer Prize winner, Ronan Farrow, Rachel Maddow as well, all Rhodes Scholars. But like I said, you're joining a community as a Rhodes Scholar of 8,000 individuals that enthusiastically pursue their interest in many different fields and areas, okay? And this is only a selection of the highest flyers that have received this scholarship. So I just put this up here just because it is a proud moment of reflection on the prestige of this scholarship. But at the same time, you know, there have been many people every year from Adelaide Uni, Flinders, and UniSA that are elected to this scholarship. It is attainable. And I'm worried that sometimes putting up a slide like this, students are discouraged from applying because they don't think that they could ever aspire to this level. There's no need for that. It's fantastic that this happens, but we want to just put motivated individuals in a position to succeed, okay? And you can join this community as a Rhodes Scholar. So a little bit about Rhodes and Oxford itself. So as a Rhodes Scholar, you'll have access to many different resources for your academic development, including lectures at Rhodes House. You'll be part of a global network and have access to mentors in almost any field or around the world. So it's a great pleasure to get cold calls from students entering Oxford as Rhodes Scholars and what they might do in chemistry and biochemistry. And in the same way, I can pick up the phone and ask for mentorship advice on career development in my own field as well. Rhodes sponsors many retreats, and they have several allied scholarship events that help reconcile the ill-gotten wealth of Rhodes in the first place, and most notably with the Rhodes Mandela scholarships. And these provide a very important bond to the scholars from Africa, where the wealth of the scholarship was first made. There are joint competitive scholarship events. You'll join like the Gates Cambridge scholars or many of the Marshall scholars from the US, they'll have events together where you get to meet other like-minded individuals interested in doing good things. And there are many social events sponsored by Rhodes House as well. Oxford itself, as you heard from Taruna when she was discussing the Cambridge Australia scholarships, Oxford is in many ways like Cambridge. It has self-governing financially independent colleges that make up the university. So if you do a second BA or a second BS, all of your tuition, all of your studying is within this college with a very small group of individuals, maybe no more than six. So the college identity and which college you apply for is probably most important if you're doing a BA or a BS or a taught master's. If you're doing a DPhil, it's probably less important. I would encourage you to join a college because it's quite a fun experience. I mean, you get to dine in places like this and live in accommodation that was built in the 1380s, perhaps. The college provides financial support, various scholarships to go to conferences, and formal dinners and social events. Oxford University has about 10,000 postgraduate students. So if you're interested in doing a DPhil, you'll be doing your research with an amazing set of people from all over the world. 61% at my last count of the postgraduate students at Oxford are from outside the UK. And just in my research group alone, where I did my DPhil, and I'm somewhere hidden in this massive group of chemistry and biochemistry researchers, over the 5 years I was at Oxford, I had the pleasure of working with people from more than 30 countries. I mean, that's incredible, right? I mean, Oxford and Cambridge as well, they're magnets for the most talented and motivated students in the world. And so you're in this, you have this critical mass of people who are creative and energetic and brilliant, and you can thrive and improve yourself by just being around these talented and motivated individuals. Oxford is a fantastic place socially. And the top right is New College, so that's where I lived for just over a year while I was at Oxford. The bottom right is the dining hall where you can take breakfast, lunch, and dinner should you choose. There is a thriving pub culture that has been going strong for centuries. And the top left, the Eagle and Child, is where C.S. Lewis and Tolkien discussed their latest manuscripts, so there's a romantic connection to history. And the Turf Tavern in the bottom left is where Bob Hawke famously broke the world record for downing a yard of beer. So there is some good fun at Oxford. So that's all I have for you. I'll be available for questions after the event. Please take note of the contact details. My mobile number is up there. Give me a text message or a call if you want to meet to discuss your application. My role is to help prepare you to put forth a competitive application and give you a realistic expectation of what will happen through the selection process. If I'm not available, please reach out to my colleague John Williams at the University of Adelaide. We look forward to your applications, and best of luck in whatever scholarship opportunities you pursue. Cheers.